So if you're a guitar player, you probably know, but the satisfaction you get from opening a beautiful case and grabbing a beautiful guitar like this out of it is just unmatched. My name is Kanad, and today we're going to talk about this beautiful Maybach Teleman T54. Now, I want to use this video to talk to you about the brand Maybach and about this guitar specifically, but first let's hear it, and then we're going to get with the history of Maybach and what they do and what they offer, and after that we're going to take a look at this guitar specifically. So my first experience with Maybach guitars was at 42 Gear Street, where I played their custom shop models made by the legendary guitar builder Nick Page. Now, if you've seen any content from 42 Gear Street, you're gonna know that most of the people there literally adored these guitars. In fact, I did a video with Paul Davids about two of those guitars, so I'm gonna put a link here or here, so click and you're gonna find that video. So as I said, in this video, I also wanted to talk about the history of Maybach, what they do and what they represent. I absolutely love Maybach guitars. So let's say I'm living the dream and all guitar companies want me to be their endorser, and I get offers from Gibson and Fender and PRS. I would actually choose Maybach guitars to be my brand of guitars, because I mean, I've played a handful of them and they've all been amazing, like jaw-dropping good. So I would really, and the thing is, they have a lot of guitars that they produce, like start from Telecasters to Strats to single cuts and hollow bodies, and they make amazing guitars. Like, I've never played a bad Maybach or anything. So yeah, if I'm living the dream, Maybach would be my guitar brand. I mean, this guitar itself single-handedly brought me my Tele addiction back, because there was a time where I was just crazy about Teles, and that just faded away. But then I got this and it just started back again. So it's this guitar's fault. And now I really want a thin line Telecaster. I've watched a lot of Anderton videos lately that they've been doing videos with thin line Telecasters. And also Paul has done a video with his Butterscotch Telecaster that's thin line. And I really want one of those as well. But I mean, it's just this one. Fantastic. All right, so let's talk about Maybach guitars, as we promised. So I was able to find a really cool video on the guitar channel where Tony Goetz, the owner of Maybach, gets interviewed. And I have to say, I learned a lot of new things that I didn't know about Maybach guitars that are really cool, and I wanted to give you a summary and share those thoughts with you. I'm gonna leave the link of the video under the description down below. You can check the whole thing. It's about 30 minutes long. But I would definitely recommend it. The interviewer did a great job, and Tony does a great job explaining what they want to do with Maybach. So to summarize, I'm going to give you all the points of that video. First and foremost, Maybach guitars are designed in Germany, and they are made in the Czech Republic. So Tony in that video explains to us that these guitars are actually made by very skilled and experienced luthiers. Tony met these guys 30 years ago and became friends with them. And they're actually mostly Fender and Gibson employees. They used to work for Fender and Gibson. And some of them actually were responsible for making the European Epiphones, which are very sought after. And they opened a factory in the Czech Republic where they produce Maybach guitars. From what I gather from the video, it's a really cool operation. And it's not something like you would see in the Far East, like where they just chuck out guitars nonstop. I mean, for example, this one, I heard on the video that it's actually 50% hand built. So what that means is it's finished by hand. And even if I didn't know all these facts from that video, I still would have said that this is a hand built instrument because it just feels amazing. Like the neck on it is a masterpiece and everything feels right on it. So there's also aging going on, so that has to be handmade. And it's just a fantastic guitar, to say the least. Now, another thing that really caught my attention from that interview is the fact that Maybach, they have two people that go to their wood sources and they actually cherry pick every wood that goes on their guitars. Which, I mean, that's kind of incredible, because if you see brands like PRS, they're gonna charge you a premium for that. And I mean, this guitar costs around $1,700. Which means it's around the Fender American Professional range. I can definitely say that this could match up a custom shop any day of the week. From the aging, the pickups, the build quality, I can definitely say that this matches a custom shop Fender. So what they do is they make sure that they get quality wood that is not so heavy, and they have different criterias for weight on the guitars. It's really cool to hear that someone that's building your guitar is actually just picking the wood, and they never buy wood sight unseen, which is just awesome in my opinion. Not only that, but they actually studied vintage guitars. So they had a couple of examples of real vintage guitars, like a real Telecaster, a 54 Telecaster. So they study that and they saw what they can bring to the table, like what the specs really are and how close they can get to it. For example, the 54, this one, most of the 54 Telecasters, or Nocasters, I believe, or Broadcasters, I don't know. They're mostly made out of pine wood. And this is exactly that. This is a sugar pine body with a maple neck. And it just has a, and in my opinion, it has a softer tone to it and a softer touch, which I prefer, as opposed to Swamp Ash, which has that twangy tone, which I do enjoy as well. But I feel like this type of guitar and the playing style that I have, just like that sugar pine body, just works perfectly for me. So to summarize it, their ultimate goal is to produce guitars that are accessible to people, that are not very expensive, because as we know, vintage guitars can be very expensive, and also custom shop guitars from manufacturers like Fender or Gibson can cost an arm and a leg. So their goal is to put together a guitar that is really good, good quality, great craftsmanship, good parts overall. So for example, the hardware is all made in Japan, CTS pots, Switchcraft switch, Amber pickups made in Germany. So there is definitely a quality to this guitar that as soon as you pick it up, you're gonna notice that you're playing an awesome guitar. And not to mention that case that you saw earlier, that's just a beautiful case. It looks beautiful. The latches work perfectly, and it's padded very well. So I have no bad things to say about Maybach guitars. I just love them. All right, so let's talk about this guitar specifically. First, we're gonna hear it a little bit in a different loop that I made. And then we're gonna talk about the specs and everything that this guitar has, go through the pickups, and that's how it's gonna go. Also for today, I'm plugged into the Vox AC10. Incredible amp that goes really well with this guitar. It's not that I would love to have it a little bit more cranked, but it's actually like 7 p.m. and I can crank it to the level that I want to, but it's totally fine. I think it sounds awesome. And I have it plugged through the HX Amp XL for the loops and distortions and everything like that. All right, so without further ado, let's listen to it, and we're gonna come back to talk about the specs and everything.
Thank you.
So in my channel's fashion, we're gonna start from the headstock and move our way down to the body and talk about all the specs. So the headstock, I think it looks just beautiful. There's aging going on. I don't know if the camera can get that, but there's some finish cracking, some dents. It just looks so natural in my opinion. So here's the back of the headstock, the tuners and the serial number. And again, there's still some aging going on around here. I think it looks just beautiful. The nut is a bone nut. It's cut perfectly fine. It's actually very low and it feels very good to play here. Let me give you a close up of that. Now the neck is a maple neck. It's a one piece maple neck and that's why it has the skunk stripe. And since we're at it, you can take a look at the neck. It has a little bit of flame to it, but it's not that flamey. And the fretboard is also maple. So the fretboard is not that tinted, unlike the classic vibe right there. That one is really tainted. It's almost orange, but this one just looks classy. And there is finish on it, but it feels like it's satin because the finish is nitro and it doesn't stick to your hands at all. I mean, it's just really comfortable. And I really like the feel of this neck. The shape of it is like a 50s neck. It's not very thick, but it's not thin either. I don't know how to call it. Like, it's in between a medium neck and a fat neck. It's just, I think for me, for example, I think it's just perfect. Now, I couldn't find any information about the frets, but to me, they feel like medium jumbo. They're highly polished. The ends are perfectly smoothed out. There's no high frets or anything like that. It just plays like a dream. And as I said, the interesting part of this is that it's a 7.25 inch radius and it plays better than my PRS, for example, which is a 10 inch radius. And that's kind of bothering me because it doesn't have to be this good, you know? It's just amazing. All right, so moving down to the body, as I said, it's a sugar pine body. And I'm gonna post some pictures because I can't seem to get the aging on camera right now. But I mean, it's subtle in some places. It's a bit more radical, but I feel like, I mean, it just gives you that vibe of like an old guitar, which is really cool. And I really like it. It's tastefully done. It's not overdone. And the finish on it is butterscotch, but it's nicotine aged, which means that they're trying to emulate the fact that someone smoked while playing this guitar, or this guitar was just being held in smoky bars or something like that. That's why you have this slight discoloration. So like it's a bit lighter here and then it gets darker in some places. I mean, there's a lot of attention to detail that goes to making a guitar like this. The pots and the switch, as I said, are CTS. In fact, the switch is a Switchcraft switch. The pickups in here are amber pickups made in Germany. And in fact, the neck one is custom made only for these Maybach guitars. The scratch plate is a single ply Bakelite scratch plate. And yeah, you can remove this sticker if you want to. The bridge is a Wilkinson by Goto, made in Japan. And these barrels, these saddles look just amazing. And they feel really good. They're really smooth when you palm mute. They don't bother you at all when you palm mute or anything like that. Now, the back as well is aged. There's some finish cracking going on, but I can't seem to get them on camera. But I'm gonna post a couple of pictures right now for you to see more clearly. And I mean, that's about it. It's a Telecaster, it's a simple design. It's a beautiful guitar, in my opinion. I mean, I don't think it can get any better than this. Unless you're looking for a different vibe and you desperately want a thin line Telecaster, which I'm losing sleep about, but that's besides the point. I mean, I have literally nothing bad to say about this guitar. It's perfect. If you're looking to buy a custom shop Fender and you just don't want to spend the money and you can find a Maybach guitar, give that a shot, play it. If you don't like it, don't buy it, but I'm more than 100% that you're gonna like it. As I said, if there was a guitar company that wants to endorse me, I would desperately want it to be Maybach. All right, so that was about it when it comes to specs, but like the most important thing is how the guitar feels. And as I said, this neck right here is a masterpiece. I mean, it's not just a baseball neck that you have to fight to play, and it's not really thin that you don't have anything to hold on to. It's just the perfect size. At least for me, it is. But as I said, the setup on this, it's actually the best setup guitar that I've gotten out of the box. It's the action is perfect right where I want it. It's actually really low for, as I said, a 7.25-inch radius, but it just works. I mean, it sings above the 12th fret, which is a really good sign when it comes to choosing a guitar. And I think the Sugar Pine body, there's something special about it because it just resonates, and it has this low mid frequency that I really like when it just like vibrates. Another thing that I like is the soft attack that it has. Even on the bridge pickup and through a Vox amp, which is notoriously trebly, the soft attack, it just makes you feel good when you play this guitar. Said it has this touch, has this dynamic to it that is really sweet, and I really enjoy it. Like, just listen to this. And the neck pickup, it sounds so beautiful. I mean, this guitar and that amp, I can play all day. As I said, you can't get any better than this. So let me try to play more good notes, because that was just terrible notes. And so you can hear all the pickups. We're gonna start with the neck pickup, everything full up, and it sounds like this. Middle position. And last but not least, the bridge pickup. Some gain. I mean, the Telecaster can do anything, right? So, as I said, it's perfect. I mean, there's nothing bad to say about it. It sounds amazing. It inspires me to play differently. It just inspires me to play overall. So, fantastic guitar. Really, really, really good. And also, they have different kinds of colors, different kinds of configurations, like rosewood necks and all that. They also have thin line Telecasters. But yeah, I mean, check out their website, Maybach Guitars. And I'll also leave a link to the website under the description down below. And as I said, do yourself a favor and try to find one and try to play one, and you're probably gonna buy it. So if you want to blame me for that, be my guest. I would love to hear that. All right, so that's gonna be it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for your time and your support. If you haven't, please subscribe to the channel if you like the content, if you like what I do. Leave a like on the video and leave a comment. I want to hear your thoughts. And if you have any questions about the guitar, of course, leave them under the comment section down below. If I don't have an answer, I'll reach out to Maybach Guitars and I'll get you sorted. But Again, if you like the content that I do, the best way to support me is to subscribe, like, and comment. And yeah, that's gonna be about it. Thank you so much for your time and have a good one. Bye-bye.